What's up, everybody? It's your boy AB from Smokin and Grillin with AB, and this is the first of three how-to videos on the Blackstone griddle. Now, this is a partnership between myself and Walmart, and in this video, we're getting ready to show you guys how to season a Blackstone griddle. Now, look, let me go ahead and walk you guys through the Blackstone griddle so you guys can see, you know, what it has to offer, and then we're gonna talk about the seasoning. Level up your outdoor cooking with a Blackstone original four burner 36-inch propane griddle and with a hood and omnivore griddle plate. This griddle is designed to heat up quickly and evenly. It's built with Blackstone's patented omnivore griddle plate technology, preventing warping, and uses less fuel so you can enjoy more predictable cooking. It has 768 square inches of cooking area and four independently heating zones that give you enough room to cook all your favorites with precision. Storage bin rails and an accessory bin provide additional storage for items needed throughout the cooking process. The addition of a side shelf cutting board, paper towel holder, and the side shelf tool hooks keep all your prep tools in one place, making food prep more efficient. Now here are some fun additions, right? Such as like a bottle opener, magnetic toolbar, and a hood with a non-slip handle that make, you know, your cooking delicious meals on the griddle much, much easier. Now what we're getting ready to do is we're gonna talk about why do we season, right? I got two things for you. First, listen, we wanna create a non-stick surface. That's why we do put the layer on there, we add the heat, right? And then we let it cool, and then we just build it up. And secondly, which is really, really important itself, is listen, we wanna get rid of any chemicals that was left over in the making process, right? All right, so the first step, listen, we wanna take a rag, or you guys can use a paper towel. I don't suggest using a paper towel because it might leave, it's kind of like rough in the very beginning. It might leave some of the little lint or something like that on there, right? So I just have some warm, soapy water. Right, and what I want to do is I just want to go over this and wipe it. Then the next step, I want to go ahead and get myself a paper towel here, right? And I just want to make sure that we wipe it completely dry. It helps that we out here in the sun, you know what I mean? So it's going to help make sure anything evaporates. Okay, so look, after we get everything, we've cleaned everything, wiped it down, we patted it dry, and then out here in the sun too, it's gonna make sure, it's gonna ensure that it's dry. When you properly season, you know, your griddle plate, look, it helps prevent rust, you know what I mean? It protects it, and this will ensure that you guys will have it, you know, for a long, long time, right? So now I'm getting ready to turn my burners on. Just push this button here. You can look down and look through the crack. You can see that all of the burners are lit, right? I got it up here on a high, right? We want to go ahead and just get some of this metal right here to open up his pores. Okay, so I'm gonna ask you guys to come here. Listen, it's been on. You can see the plate is hot. What we're doing is we're cooking it right now. The pores are open, and we're starting to get rid of anything that was not picked up with the initial scrubbing, you know, with the soapy water, right? So if you can look at it, I hope you guys can see it. It's burning off a lot right here. Now, this process right here takes about 10 to 15 minutes. I'm gonna just say, I'm gonna let it go for 15 minutes. You'll notice that you'll have a little bit of a different color on your griddle. Then I'm gonna turn everything off, and then we're gonna apply, you know, whatever type of oil that we're gonna use, right? Now I want you guys to pay attention over this way. Look, this is what I normally do it with. I have another Blackstone that you guys don't see right now. You know, my griddle, this is what I use. This is the griddle, you know, seasoning made by Blackstone. You guys can use a cooking oil, whatever the smoke point with that. That's good, because once you put it on there, and once it quits smoking, you know that it has done its thing. And then check it out, folks, bacon grease. You pick your own oil, whichever one you want to use, that's what you use. All right, so look, I don't know if it was capturing it before when, you know, when this little light smoke that was coming off of there. Now you just want to get yourself, now you do this and I apply everything, you know, with a paper towel right here, right? So you'll see it, it's going to start to heat up. You're going to want to get yourself a lot of this. And what we want to do is we just want to get this nicely coated. I still have the fire on underneath. Then we're gonna get some tools too. Now, once I got it evenly coated on here, look at this. Now, everything that you put on here has a smoke point, right? So I'm gonna let this go until the heat, you know, till I don't see any more smoke. Then I'm gonna turn it off, and then we're gonna let it cool gradually, right? And then I'm gonna probably repeat that process for a minimum of three times, right? Five will be ideal. You know what I mean? But we're gonna do it for just three times. Look at that right there. Look at the color of the griddle. And we working, folks. All right, so listen, I let this go until after all of my, you know, my seasoning oil that was on here, once it's gone, I don't see any more smoke. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn everything off. right? We're gonna let it completely cool. Once it's cool, I'm gonna repeat the process a minimum of two more times, so for a total of three. Okay, so listen, it has completely cooled down for its third time, and this is what we're looking at right here. Listen, I told you in the perfect conditions, I like to do it five times, you know what I mean? But this right here, we can start to cook, right? So it's completely cool, and I wanna let you know, listen, regular maintenance would be, you wanna clean this after you get through, and then you wanna season it. You know, just wanna put a light cover of your seasoning on there just to preserve everything, right? So with that being said, you guys got it. This is the Blackstone Griddle, and this is one of three. How to season your griddle. Now don't forget, this is a partnership between Walmart and myself, and we're getting you ready to use the Blackstone Griddle in time for Memorial Day. And don't forget, this is part one of a three-part series of the how-tos, so let's get it.